parents and kids, welcome to our online kids services. We're so, so happy that you could join us today, because today we are talking about a series about... All parents and kids, welcome to our kids online services. We are so, so happy that you can join us, because today we're talking about a series about kids who did amazing things for God in the Bible, even though they were too young. See, friends, you must never believe that you are too young for God to use your willingness and obedience to grow His kingdom. Today, we're going to talk about a young girl who was not ashamed to talk about God and how that led to God making a miracle happen through her. Let's enjoy the service together.
Hi everyone. I am so happy to see you again. I need to talk to you about something. I know I always need to tell the truth, but I am a little scared to talk to Uncle Fred because I broke his favorite coffee mug. I do not want to lie to him and say that it was not me, but I also do not want him to be angry at me. Has that ever happened to you? Oh, so I'm not the only one. Will you please help me to talk to Uncle Fred? But maybe we must first sing a song before we go to Uncle Fred. That always makes me feel better.
And friends, do you have a question for me again?
No, not really. I need to tell Uncle something.
Okay. I am all ears.
When Uncle Fred was looking for your favorite coffee mug this morning, I didn't say anything, but I actually knew where it was.
Oh, I was wondering why you were so quiet in this morning.
I'm really, really sorry, but I accidentally dropped the mug and it broke. I did not want to say anything because I was afraid that Uncle Fred would be angry with me.
Oh, Artie, I actually saw the broken pieces in the dustbin. I am very happy you did not lie to me. It took a lot of courage to tell me the truth. I am very proud of you.
So Uncle Fred is not angry at me. Thank you so much. But what does courage mean?
It is when you are brave enough to do something even when you might get into trouble. Like when you know somebody might be angry at you when you tell the truth.
Also, if you are not scared to tell the truth, then you have courage.
Yes, there is a Bible verse that you can learn and even pray to help you with this. It is in Acts 4, verse 29. Lord, enable your servant to speak your word with great boldness.
Acts 4, verse 29. Lord, enable your servants to speak your word with great boldness. My friends and I are going to learn it so that it can be placed in our hearts and we will never forget it.
That is good. There is a Bible story about a young girl who had courage. Let's take a look.
Hey, it's Bible Netflix time!
The Bible tells us all about what God is saying and doing so that we can get to know God better. It's the story of the God who made people in His image and likeness to reign over all He created. Everything in the Bible points us to Jesus, and Jesus shows us the Father. So when we read the Bible, it helps us to know God, love people, and impact our world.
Telling you a story about a brave young girl who got caught while there was a war between Syria and Israel. She then worked as a servant girl for the general of the army's wife. The general's name was Naaman.
What is a general?
A general is the head of an army, and they were very, very rich. The rich people in those days had servants, and the servant girl had to do everything that the rich man's wife asked. If she was thirsty, she had to go fetch her something to drink. If she needed something, she was the one who had to go and run and fetch it for her. She was only referred to as the young girl in the Bible.
Maybe
they
never asked what her name was.
Maybe, maybe not, but she was always in her place and ready to help, and she believed in God, and when she heard about Naaman's terrible skin disease, she knew exactly what to do.
What skin disease was it?
This skin disease is a terrible disease called leprosy. Leprosy makes you very, very itchy, and it's very painful to the touch. Especially if you bump into something or someone touches you. The servant girl saw how much pain Naaman was in, and she said to his wife, "Oh, how I wish he could meet the prophet who lives in Samaria." It took a lot of courage to say that, because she knew that these two countries were at war and were enemies.
Wasn't she afraid?
Yes, I think she must have been, but she believed in God, and she knew that Prophet Elisha is a man of God and would be able to heal Naaman. Naaman's wife believed her and told her husband about the prophet. Naaman told then the king about the prophet, and the king immediately sent a letter to the king of Israel asking them if they could heal Naaman. When the king of Israel saw what the letter said, he got angry and said, "How can the king of Syria expect me to heal this man? Does he think I am God?"
Maybe he wanted to fight again.
Yes, but Elisha said to the king, "Send this man to me and I will show him that there is a true prophet of God in Israel." Naaman went to Israel, and when he got there, Elisha sent a servant out to tell him to go to the Jordan River.
Why did you have to go to the river?
Naaman also didn't understand this, and he was very angry. he said that he thought Elisha would pray for him and he just wanted to go home.
That was a very strange message. Did he go home?
No, the servants of Naaman convinced him that he should at least try, as he had come all that way. So Naaman went down to the Jordan River and he dipped himself in the river 7 times, just as Elisha told him to. After the 7th time, he was healed. His skin was as soft as a baby.
Wow, I'm sure he can't wait to go home and show everybody.
That's right, but he first went to Elisha and he said to Elisha, I know now that your God is the only true God there is, the God of Israel. What a wonderful story. And to think that everything started with a little girl whose name we don't even know.
Yes, but after the little girl, Naaman will never be healed.
Yes, God chose that little girl so that he could do a miracle and so that others could get to know him. Just like that, he also wants to use you and you to help others to get to know him too.
I want to tell everyone about Jesus too. In his goodness.
Wow, what a wonderful story about a girl that nobody even knew about. Still, she chose to be courageous.
Yes, the young girl was not scared or too shy to talk about what God can do, even though nobody served God in the country she lived in.
Uncle Fred, that means we can also talk about God's truth even though we are young. I will pray this Bible verse every day, so that I will not be afraid or too shy to tell others about Jesus. Friends, are you going to do it with me? Let us go on our knees with our hands folded and say the verse together. Acts 4 verse 29. Lord, enable your servants to speak your word with great boldness.
It was beautiful to see everybody talk to God. He wants to help us to have courage every day. When you see somebody hurt a friend, you can go and help your friend or tell someone else who can help.
Yes, and we can tell a friend that uses bad language that it is not nice to talk like that.
Yes, that's right. May you have courage to always speak the truth and not to lie because you are afraid to get into trouble.
Thank you, Uncle Fred. I am so glad that we can always talk to you and Jesus. Friends, let us sing a song together.
I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that He is with me every day. He's by my side, He hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in Him. I'm gonna run, run, run to His love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the away.
So great. I just want to read our main scripture again. It's from Acts 4, verse 29. It says, empower us as your servants to speak your word freely and courageously. Freely and courageously. Those are two big words. But friends, that just really means we should not be scared. That's what we see in this young girl, because not too many people knew her, but God did something amazing through her. God wants to use us to do amazing things, even if the world says we're too young. See, friends, what that really means is that we should not be scared. And that's what we see in this young girl's life. See, not too many people knew her, but God did something amazing through her. God wants to use us to do amazing things. So may you as a family experience God's freedom to express His word freely and courageously as a family. See, remember friends, when we are faithful in the little things, God can do something amazing through us. It was so, so great spending this time with you this week, and we can't wait to do it again next week.